Okay, hello everybody. This is the first coding class that I'm going to do, and basically it's going to be an introduction and just talk on a few things. Okay, so for the rest of the class I'll be using IntelliJ instead of Android Studio, which we actually use for Android development in the class. But there are reasons why I chose IntelliJ. IntelliJ is, should I say, more plain than Android Studio. Android Studio has a lot of components that weighs it down, and in this case I'm just trying to show you guys Kotlin, the language, not Kotlin Android. Kotlin can be used for many things, not just Android. So I'm just trying to show you the language. It's just like saying Java is not used for just Android development. Also, it's also used for that in server side and some other implementations that you want, IoT or whatever. Okay, so let's go into the business. I have my IntelliJ IDEA open. I've not updated this version, still in 2018 version. This is the community edition, so it's the one that the license is free for everyone. Okay, so I have this learn and teach open here. I'll show you guys what this is. It's actually a cool thing I found out recently, but it helps developers and teachers alike to teach and learn. Okay, so let's get started. So I'll click on create new project. Okay, so you notice this panel that comes up. There are many options, so I'll go through the options. There is Java option for you to write Java code. There is JavaFX option for you to write JavaFX applications, which is applications for what do they call it, desktop applications and whatsoever. There are also other applications of FX. I think I saw something on Gulon Mobile. There was way to write Java code to target mobile applications. It was something cool, but I use the Android platform, so I don't want to venture into those kind of adventures yet. Okay, so there's Groovy, there's Kotlin. Okay, you notice there are many options for Kotlin here. There's Kotlin / JVM, which is the Java virtual machine. There's Kotlin / JS, which is JavaScript. There's Kotlin / native. So it means Kotlin to target the Java virtual machine, to Kotlin to target JavaScript, Kotlin native. Okay, so there's others like Kotlin for JavaScript client and JVM server, multi-platform library, mobile, Android, iOS, and mobile shared library. Okay, so what I am targeting is Kotlin JVM. Okay, so click on next. Okay, so I will call this project start. Okay, because we are just starting. Okay, you notice some other settings. They are actually by default set here for us. This means I'm using Java 8. This 1.8 here means I'm using Java 8. This there's actually a Kotlin runtime, Java runtime library. It helps us run our Java Kotlin code. Okay, so this is also required to open the project. So it's not very big. From what I learned, it's just a few kilobytes. It doesn't even add. You don't even know that the runtime is there. Okay, so click on finish, and my project builds. Okay, so. So my project is now built and it's open now. So it's configure Kotlin. I'm not interested in that. Okay, so everything is done now, but the project is empty. Okay, so to do something with this project now, I need to add something. So I'll come here and add a file. I want to add a new class, a file, or sorry, not class, a file. There's a noise in my in the background. I'm somewhere that is very unconducive, and some people are making noise. So, I appreciate if you try to listen to the sound of my voice and ignore the noise. But I just have to make these videos now because I've been very busy, and this is the chance I get to make it. Okay, so you see, coding file slash class, and I'll click on that. I'll call the class main. And click enter. The Kotlin class is now created for me, and you notice here there's one class, there's one file here called main.kt. Okay, so you may have noticed in on Java, when you write Java applications, there's the entry point for the application called public static void main, then string arguments and whatever, and then this. Okay, so I will try to replicate that in Kotlin, and I'll just say func. Okay, so fun is function in Kotlin. I'll call it main. Okay, so fun main, and then I'll add the parentheses, and then this. Okay, I'll leave the this one the parentheses open for now. Okay, so what do I want this application, this function to do? I just want to print something. Okay, so write print, and then hello world or hello class. Okay, so this is just a main fun a function called main that prints this line for me. Don't be too confused about this. Just print is a function. Just know that print is a function. Okay, so I'll try to go deep into functions and other things very soon, but just know that print is a function, and I just created a function called main, which is our entry point for the application right now. So okay, so if I click on here, I'll actually run this function. So I click on run, and you notice here my application start building. Okay, so when it builds now, you see the output of the application. Okay, so yeah, so it writes hello class here, and everything is built. Okay, so that means our application runs and everything is okay. I hope you guys are following. I'm not even going too fast, so if you are lost at this point, it means that you have not actually looked at Kotlin code before. Okay, so if that's a problem, it's not bad. You can still follow up. Okay, so now everything is set. I'll start adding more things on the setup. Setup is just easy. We just created an empty project and added one Kotlin file. So we'll still use this same project to do some other things. We'll still add some other projects here. Sorry, I'll still teach some other things here so that you guys get. Okay, I think the source file, I'll post the source file later for people that want to look at it, but this is just the setup. How did I set up the application? What did I use? I chose IntelliJ for reasons why I told you guys. So rest of the course actually built on this. Okay, so try to follow up. Okay, thank you everyone, thank you for watching.